Okay, so we're in SafeNet Trusted Access. I've selected to use the SAS user ID. And that's going to correspond to my Active Directory user ID in this case. Name ID format unspecified, sorry. And then if we look at my user, and this is actually an internal user, but for a live environment, it would be a synchronized user. So we've got Jonas. And you see user. Let me highlight that user ID is Jonas. And the part of the challenge is here I need a domain prefix to query Active Directory for additional attributes to make those claims. So we're in the ADFS, claims provider trust configuration. We can just move that around so you can see it. And I've got a single rule, and this is going to follow the stall ADFS template instructions, so it takes name ID unspecified and just pass it through. And this is on the claims provider trust side of things, so I'm not doing much here, just passing it along. And then of course challenge will be at the relaying party trust configuration. So let me exit that and we have a look at relaying party trust, and I'm using a test tool from Microsoft called Claims X-ray, really helpful. And I'm going to single rule here. It's called use name identifier to issue, various claims based on Active Directory. And the first part is really defining the attribute I'm going to base my query on. So that's going to be the name identifier, which stall is passing along, and that was a bit of a challenge, but this is how it looks. And then based on that, we're going to query the store, which is Active Directory, and we're going to query for just a number of different attributes here. So the email address, the name, organization, which is company, employee ID number. And then for the final trick is, so we're using prepending a string of text there. So we have the value, which is going to be name identifier, which is Jonas coming from star, but we append or prepend the value of my, the net bias name of the domain, so svedemo. So the query will be based on svedemo/Jonas. And now let's see this in action. So I'm going to use my test tool here. This is ADFS X-ray app. So point to the STS and do a fresh authentication. I suppose that will clear the cookies and stuff. Test authentication. And my username is cached, and this gives us the response so we can easily troubleshoot. But you see that four different claims were issued based on the name identifier attribute being sent in. And that was again made possible by prepending the domain. And if you want to, look closer at this, a troubleshoot, you get the raw token, that's useful, and then Event Viewer will have a bunch of details if you hit any error in how you resolve things.